fighting Satan every day. We're standing up for Jesus while we're kneeling down to pray. If his precious blood has cleansed you and washed away your sin, that makes you a member of the blood washed band. Praise God, I'm a member of the blood washed band. I've been washed in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb. I was bound by chains of sin till one day the Master came and made me a member of the blood washed band.
God's children are advanced and march until we reach the throne.
Lord, the battle's almost over. We'll soon be going home.
I can hear the sound of angels as the saints go marching in, singing praises to the captain of the blood-washed band.
Praise God, I'm a member of the blood-washed band. I've been washed in the soul-cleansing blood of the Lamb. I was bound by chains of sin till one day the Master came.
Once more, praising the risen Lord, heaven. That's awesome,
that's
isn't
good
it?
Stuff,
that's
hey,
awesome.
Boy.
Hey, thank you all for quit talking. Thank you all for for coming to spend this time with us this afternoon. We are just thrilled to see you here. And I got to know, are you glad to see Mark Trammell over there on the end? How about Ernie Haas? How about Scott Fowler? Where's Danny Funderburk over there?
And how about Gerald Wolf?
Thank you so much. Hey, here is one of the cathedral's most requested songs. As a matter of fact, they opened their program with it, probably the last 10 years or so that they toured, right? That'll be right?
I think you're right.
I think you will recognize it from the very first note. Yeah.
Is that wedding music I hear? The bride's adorned and ready to appear. There's heavenly preparation for the wedding celebration. Is that wedding music that I hear? The family is preparing for a wedding. All have been invited to attend.
Damascus Road, he never was the same again. And when Peter met the Lord, he left his boat and started a fishing for men. Now I may not be Peter or Paul, but one thing I can truly say, when I met the Lord and made him my choice, he definitely made a change.
He made a change in the way that I'm walking. He made a change.
single life that I'm living. I'm born again, set free, finally forgiven. If he can make a change in me, he can make a change in you.
Some old friends shaking their heads, 'cause they never thought they'd see the day when a sinner like me would praise the Lord or bow my head to pray. Now I'm not what I used to be. You see, my life has been rearranged. Well, there's nothing that I've done to lie about someone who definitely made a change.
He made a change.
He made a change. The way that I'm walking,
he made a change.
He made a change in the way that I'm talking. Old things passed away. Behold, everything's new.
He made a change.
He made a change in the life that I'm living. I'm born again, set free, finally forgiven. If he can make a change in me, he can make a change in you. Away. Behold, everything's new.
Yeah.
He made a change in the life that I'm living. I'm born again, set free, finally forgiven. If he can make a change in me, he can make a change in you.
Yes, he
will.
He made a change.
He made a change in the way that I'm walking.
He made a change.
He made a change in the way that I'm talking.
Seeing you sweat.
I'm glad.
That'll make you get on your mule, won't it?
That's hard for a tenor to do before lunchtime,
oh,
man.
Oh, gosh. That's hard for a baritone singer to do before lunchtime. That's great.
Isn't this a great crowd, Gerald?
This is an awesome crowd.
Thank you for coming out.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah. Today we're going to be doing some of your favorite, all-time favorite, Cathedral Quartet songs. Of course, none of it. The truth is, you wouldn't know a single one of us standing on this platform if it had not been for George Yonts and Glenn Payne introducing us to you. That's the truth. We realize that, and so we are forever indebted to those guys and the legacy they left us, and we hope that we would never do anything to embarrass them, and so that we, when we get to heaven, we don't want them standing there looking at us, you know. I don't want to hear George say, "Why in the world did you do that?" I'll never know. So today we're going to sing some of your most requested and most favorite songs that the Cathedral's made famous, especially during the last couple of decades that they toured. And then we're going to do a couple that weren't necessarily their most popular, but that were very special to us because we knew the stories behind them. And one of them is this one that not many people know, that George was not only a great singer and the greatest MC of all time, he was also a pretty good songwriter. And this is a song that he wrote a long time ago, but they rarely sing it. And I want you to listen to this. It's a great message, it really is.
Would you put your hands together and welcome this man as he sings his number one song, Somebody Touch Me, Mr. Danny Funderburk.
Many years ago in darkness, as he groped along the streets, with his hand stretched out for pennies or for just
1 by 2 8 is the story of the blind man who met Jesus on his way. With a master's touch, the man looked up as the scoffers heard him say,
come on, help me out.
Somebody touch me. Somebody touch me.
Oh,
I was blind, but praise his name. I now can see. I was in darkness when Jesus found me. In the sense he touched me.
Move back here and sing to these folks. One day he touched that crippled man and he made him walk again. Now the master, he saw with pleasure he had labored not in vain. Like the story of that crippled man, I too was well myself.
Yes, you can, you could, you wouldn't, he did.
Come on.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'll be honest with you, and I've said this off the platform, and I'll say it on the platform, from my ear. Now, you know, all of it, we get older, and our voices change somewhat, but Mark Trammell sounds exactly the same today as he did 30 years ago.
He's like Jesus. He's like Jesus. He changeth not.
Yeah, he doesn't. I mean, that song was recorded, in 1985, right?
Yeah.
And it sounds exact to me. You sound exactly the same. You don't look the same.
No.
No.
I don't feel the same.
No,
either.
You don't. No, you don't. You don't feel the same.
Do you remember that joke? George just telling Glenn all the time. I just came to me. He said he took his little grandson, Cole, at the time was like 3 years old, to the doctor for a checkup.
Right.
And he went to the doctor and he said, "Does God make me?" And his doctor said, "Yeah." And he went to his papa, Glenn, and went like that. "Does God make him?" He goes, "Yeah." He goes, "God doing a better job these days, isn't he?" You remember that one?
Yeah.
You can use that. Hey, where's Nick Trammell? Use that on your pop on your dates. That'd be good.
I remember Nick, you know, he grew up in Stowe, Ohio. It's great to have him sitting over there. I was sitting over here at the piano listening. We're blessed to have a couple of great bass singers on the platform with us today. And, you know, of all the personnel changes that the Cathedrals had, George was the only bass singer that the group ever had. Joined the group in 1964, and he was there. I mean, he was it. There was only one other person that ever sang bass with the Cathedral Quartet, and it was during the 4 months that George was out with his first heart attack. Mm-hmm. And that person was me.
Oh!
And yes, please.
That was you?
Please remain seated.
And
yeah, you didn't know that. Well, you weren't asked before you came along. But so we decided that today we wanted to do, you know, Cathedrals are kind of known for doing a cappella stuff. And when we did the London album, we did an old Stamps Baxter song, a cappella, Heavenly Parade. And when George was out, I got to sing that Heavenly Parade every night. So I know the bass part. And why are you looking at me like that?
You're not. Are you wanting to sing the bass?
Well, that's why I came up here, because I'm going to sing.
Oh, I thought you were just going to introduce me to do that, but I mean, do you think you can pull this off? Seriously?
Well, I know the part. I mean, I can read the notes. I know, for heaven's own king, for heaven's holy king, no. So glad that we, what?
It's more, I mean, I know you can hit the notes. I know, but you got to be able to sell it, you know.
Sell it.
I mean, y'all know when George would sing, I mean, he'd sell it. He'd make you, you know, want it. You can't just hit the notes.
What do you, I mean?
I mean, I can show you,
Gerald,
you know,
do
how
it.
To do it.
There you go.
You're going to show me how to do it.
Y'all can come in here. You stand over there, and then I'll stand over here, and I'll just show you. You just do what I do. You do what I do.
Okay, let me give us the key. What is it? Is it A or B flat? What is it?
I think it's A flat.
Is it A? Or is it A?
Just pick one, honey. I don't care.
Let's do it. Is that okay? A flat?
I thought so. I may be wrong.
Can you
Let's
sing that low?
The difference. A split. I'm sorry?
Can you sing that low?
Can I sing that low? The question is, can you sing that high? That's the question here now.
Come on.
Okay. Let's do it
here
right
there.
Hey, key of A.
All right.
Y'all
got the bass part covered.
Right here.
We just pick whatever we want to. Okay. Is that the deal?
Yeah,
you take the lead.
Our traveling days will soon be over here, and we shall cross the rolling tide. For we're down here for just a little while, our home is on the other side. Ambassadors true for Jesus our Redeemer, and it is a love's crusade. For right against the wrong, but soon we'll join the throne in heaven when the saints parade. For heaven's king, for heaven's only king, so glad we shall sing the story. A blessed old story, sing it through his glory. Oh, it is heaven new, in glory like fair of yonder in the air. With that eternal happy band, we'll promenade there and ever go ahead in heaven's grand parade. So happy are we in telling you, my friend, that Jesus can redeem your soul.
from every known sin and make you pure within joy. Billows on your thin will blow. A happy new song you will begin to sing to Jesus, either way hath made. To Gloryland Fair we'll have a mansion there and join us in the saints' parade. For heaven's king, for heaven's holy king, we gladly shall sing the story. The story stories sing it to us all. It's in Gloryland Fair up yonder in the air, where the Adjourn hath been back. We'll promenade there and never know a care in heaven at the grand parade. We'll promenade in heaven's grand parade.
The Cathedral Quartet thrilled and excited crowds for over 35 years. And now you can relive those moments. Cathedral's Family Reunion is a weekend event that shares a lifetime of memories. Join Cathedral's alumni Ernie Haas of Ernie Haas and Signature Sound, Scott Fowler of Legacy 5, Gerald Wolfe of Greater Vision, Mark Trammell of the Mark Travel Quartet, and Danny Funderburk as they share funny road stories, reminisce about concert experiences, and sing the classic Cathedral songs you love. Take a step back in time as you walk through the last tour bus of the cathedrals. Experience the cathedral's journey firsthand as you browse the extensive memorabilia exhibit full of personal as well as professional cathedral artifacts. Meet other cathedrals fans and share your favorite Cathedral Quartet moments. Cathedral's Family Reunion, reliving the legacy.
I'm telling you, if you get the opportunity, if we get close enough to your area, and we don't get to do many of these, but it's a great two-day event. Coming up, our next one, we're actually going back to Akron, Ohio, where it all started, on November the 7th and the 8th. So if you can get to Akron, it's going to be a very special 2 days there. We'll have all the groups there, Ernie Haas, Signature Sound, Mark Trammell Quartet, Legacy 5, Greater Vision. We'll do a concert on Friday night like that. Saturday morning, we'll do road stories and just go to the piano and sing old cathedral songs. And then Saturday night, we'll do a major concert, that all cathedral material with the band and all. So it's going to be a wonderful thing, November 7th and 8th. And then we have others planned for next year as well. I hope you'll get one of these flyers because we're coming to Orlando, Florida, actually the Winter Park, Florida area in January. And then we'll be in Fort Worth, Texas, November 14th and 15th of this year. We'll be in Westminster, Colorado. That's the Denver area next April. Then Lancaster, Pennsylvania, July. Branson, Missouri on October 9th and 10th. So make sure you get one of these flyers because on this flyer, there is a special code that you can use when you go to purchase your tickets, and it'll save you $10 if you use the code. So make sure you get one of these flyers, and you can get it back here at the product table and on that side of the room this afternoon. So pick that up and be with us at one of the Cathedral Family Reunions. I promise you, it'll be two of the best days of your year this year.
Sarah, would you let me just say something here quickly? We don't have a lot of time.
Absolutely.
But Gerald mentioned the truth, and that is that you wouldn't know any of us if it weren't for George and Glenn. But in addition to that, just me personally, I've got to tell you that I miss my best friend in the world, Roger Bennett. I miss all of them, but Roger was just my best friend, and I'll never forget auditioning for the cathedrals. Ernie, you'll remember. Mark, you'll remember. I met you in the lobby of the hotel in Odessa, Texas. And Mark met me, and he said, man, rooms...
Holiday Inn in Odessa, Texas.
What room?
228, but that don't matter.
I think that's
what does matter is he still has a Holiday Inn towel on the bus.
I just borrowed it. I'm taking it back.
I'll never forget that day, my audition day. You met me in the lobby, and he said, man, go up there, just relax, you're going to be fine. And I didn't do what he said. I wasn't relaxed. I wasn't fine. But Roger was there, And I'll never forget singing, him playing that little electric keyboard. And he'd just look up at me, and he'd wink, and he'd nod, and he was encouraging me. He knew how nervous I was. He knew how out of my league I was. And so I really miss Roger. We still get people who will come to the table and ask us for Roger Bennett songs. And this one, I want you to watch the screen, because this one is probably his most popular.
I've been reading in the Bible about the ending of the age. And one thing that's for certain, it grows closer every day. But I am not concerned about the way it's gonna end. 'Cause I've read the back of the book and we win.
Yeah. I've read the back of the book and we win. No more living in darkness, we'll be living at home with him.
There ain't no need to worry about it if you're born again. 'Cause
I've read the back of the book and we win.
Now we all wanna be winners in the games of life that we play. But friends, since I'm a sinner, I've already lost the race. But Jesus' blood can take my sin and throw it in the deep blue sea. He'll put an end to my last place living. He'll give me the victory.
I've read the back of the book and we win. No more living in darkness, we'll be living at home with him.
There ain't no need to worry about it if you're born again. 'Cause
I've read the back of the book.
Happened to be a part of the group still when this young man came along. The last of the tenors that I would sing with in the rotation during my years with the Cathedral Quartet. When he came, he began to sing a song that I had, as a lad, heard a man by the name of Rosie Roselle sing. And I thought, no one will ever sing this song like Rosie. Don't make that boy do that. But he took it and he made it his own. And you're about to hear it right now. You listen as Ernie sings for you. Oh, what a Savior.
Within, I see. They searched through heaven and found a Savior to
oh.
hear you.
His heart was broken
on Calvary.
On Calvary.
Raise your voice to him and sing.
His hands were nailed to
the cross. Sign was riven. Sing that line again. He gave his life's blood.
He gave his
life. That's beautiful. Sing it again, but say, Jesus gave.
Jesus gave his life's blood
for even me.
For even me.
Great. When you were singing, that was one of George's favorite things, was to hear people sing. I don't know how many concerts you went to, but if you went to cathedral concerts, you know they were most known for they'd walk out on the platform and they just had a piano and a bass guitar. That was it. And then they would use a few tracks. They were one of the first groups I ever heard use a soundtrack. Sunshine and Roses, 1978. It was on a cassette. That was their track.
On a cassette?
Yeah. How old were you in 1978?
Oh, I think I was still forming eyelids at that time. I don't know.
No.
No. I'm 78. I was a freshman in high school.
Were you really?
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, I'd have guessed you a lot older than that. But anyway.
Thank you.
But they would just come out and, you know, and they would use these big tracks, but they were the best, I think, in my opinion, when it was just piano.
Absolutely.
And bass and those four wonderful voices. Would you agree with that?
Yep.
So we're gonna do some of those. We're going to do some.
Step into the water.
Yeah.
Way down a little bit deeper. Wet your feet in the water of his love. Step into the water, way down a little bit deeper. Come join angels singing praises to the Lamb of God.
It's time we the people stand up for what is right. It's time we squared our shoulders back and raise our sword to fight. For the Bible is my weapon, and the Spirit is my shield. The church needs more of its members to be workers in the field.
Step into the water, way down a little bit deeper. Wet your feet in the water of his love. Oh, step into the water, way down a little bit deeper. Come join angels singing praises to the Lamb of God, to the Lamb of God.
There is victory for the Christian who walks the narrow way. There has been a prize appointed for the soul who does not stray. Oh, I want to live for Jesus and be all that I should be, so that I can rest with him forever, live eternally.
Step into the water, way down a little bit deeper. Wet your feet in the water of his love. Oh, step into the water,
children,
way down a little bit deeper. Come join angels singing praises to the Lamb of God. Step into the water, way down a little bit deeper.
singing, come join angels singing praises to you.
Dude. somewhere beyond the blue. Somewhere a mansion waiting in that eastern sky. Maybe next door to you. With a parade of the distant stars.
Right down the
Milky Way. Right down the Milky Way.
The planets to
the planets to return.
That's good, homie.
And when my mansion's ready, yes, I'm gonna move right in. I have a vision of a happy place where floods of love was me. Right on the corner
of Love's Avenue
and Hallelujah
Street.
Oh, yes, I'm moving, 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 moving up to glory land. I'm moving, 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 all into his scar hand.
Don't know when I'm leaving, but I'm ready to go. When I get to heaven, I'll be welcome, I know.
Don't you know I'm moving, 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 moving up to glory land. Oh, yes, I'm moving, 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 moving,
moving up to glory land.
Oh, yes, I'm moving. Let's go. Here we go.
Don't know when I'm leaving, but I'm ready to go. When I get to heaven, I'll be welcome, I know.
Don't you know I'm moving, 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 moving,
moving, moving up to glory land.
Moving, moving.
That will last through all eternity.
old are you again?
I'm going to kill Mark Trammell. The quartet thing is you don't quit ending the note until the baritone stops. And right. He's over just holding it out, just making me work hard.
Where was it we were one night? We were somewhere together one night. I think it was Lancaster. And just on the platform, and people just started yelling song titles out of the audience. I mean, that's the way those people are.
Yeah.
And they kept yelling out a song that we just really did not want to do because we had, honestly, had never practiced it, and we didn't know if we could do it right. But finally, I looked at Pat standing there, and I said, do you know this song? And he said, yeah, I think I do. And so he sang it that night. You remember that? Mm-hmm. For the first time ever.
Oh, yeah.
And
yeah.
I'm going to walk it up from the... I want you... You know which song I'm talking about, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Today I went back to the place where I used to go. Today I saw that same old crowd I knew before. When they asked me what had happened, I tried to tell them, thanks to Calvary, I don't come here anymore. Thanks to Calvary, I am not the man I used to be. Thanks to Calvary, things are different than before. While the tears ran down my face, I tried to tell them, thanks to Calvary, I don't come here anymore. But then we went back to the house where we used to live. My little boy ran and hid behind the door. I said, son, don't be afraid. You've got a brand new daddy now. And thanks to Calvary, we don't live here anymore. Hallelujah. Thanks to Calvary, I am not the dad I used to be. Thanks to Calvary, things are different than before. While the tears ran down my face, I tried to tell him, we don't live here. No. Thank God. We don't live here anymore. Anymore.
Good job.
Jesus.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention? I'd like to introduce to you in this corner, robed in white, stands a champion. And he is the all-time undisputed, undefeated champion of love. Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention? I want to introduce to you in this corner of the good and the right stands a champion robed in white. His height exceeds the heavens. His weight outweighs the world. His reach reaches everywhere. His age is evermore. He is higher than the highest, greater than the great. No one will ever take his crown away. He is more mighty than the mightiest. He reigns from above. He's the all-time undisputed, undefeated champion of love. He left his hometown to enter this arena, to raise his hands in victory for all of you and me. But an angry crowd crucified this king who wore their crown, and they gladly watched the champion going down. But I will never count him out, for I'm a witness of the day he arose to retain the title champion of love. He is higher than the highest, greater than the great. No one will ever take his crown away. He's more mighty than the mightiest. He reigns from
because we want to. We don't stand up as long as we used to, do we, Glenn?
We don't do nothing as long as we used to. What are you talking about?
Ask and you shall receive, you know. My, what a You know, 55 years for Glenn, 53 years for me, and December the 9th, 10th, and 11th in Akron, Ohio will be our last three concerts. And we don't even think about it from concert to concert because
can't.
We'd never get through it. We really wouldn't. So we push it back in our minds.
It's emotional.
It is an emotional time for us. And so many people have
right. But you know what?
What?
I already got my application in.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to be a Walmart reader.
Here's your cart. Let me know what Walmart. I'm going to wear you out, amen. I love people. I really do. About 35 years ago, we was in, you remember that, in New Orleans, Louisiana, one Sunday afternoon. A lady hollered out of the audience for us to sing this song. And I said, Glenn, I'll do the melody, and you pick out a harmony part. In a loudmouth, ungodly, vile, vulgar, crime-filled world, where we're seeing things we never dreamed we'd see,
right.
Hearing things we never dreamed we'd hear, and my heart bleeds, and I'm sure you're all like I am, and you feel so helpless at what's going on, the pain of those people, and you say, man, the world's out of control. No. God still has everything under control. How long has it been since you asked the Lord to search you?
his
yeah, thank you.
People were gathered hoping to see him as thousands were fed. The blind eyes, he healed broken spirits, he moved with compassion. Why, he raised up the dead.
This afternoon, give him another hand.